Hello everyone, my name is Greg and I dev stuff. Welcome everyone to the episode 10 of Yakuza Like Game in Unity. In this episode we will implement money and running money text. Today we will implement money and running money counter. So when you pick up money, counter will run through numbers instead of immediately changing the state to your current amount of money. This will make the effect of acquiring more money feels more cool and impactful. Select the player, create another new script called currency. Inside, define a new serialized variable called money. And now we need to show this value on the screen. Go back to the editor and create a new panel and place text in it. Create a new script called int text counter on this text object. Open the newly created script. This script will be responsible for showing the value of your money and making it running counting towards the new value instead of simply updating the text on the screen. Get and store reference to the text component. Let's make public method setTo, where we will pass the int value and we will set our text to this value. In the currency script, create serialized reference for int text counter. Set the int text counter in the editor. And on start, assign the value. Let's test this. Good. This will set the text on the screen to the money value at the start. Let's make it possible to add more money to player. And we want to add a handy test methods, which will allow us to test the system easily at the runtime. Forgot to call an update on the money counter. Now we want to add those test methods to the context menu, so we can easily call those test methods through context menu. Good. Now we want to make it so numbers will run when you modify the money count. Open int text counter and inside create a new method called moveTo. Create a new variable called currentValue, where we will store currentValue of the text counter, which will be visible on the screen. Set it in the setTo. In moveTo, we want to make it so the past value will be the new variable called targetValue, to which current value will slowly count towards. In the update, we want to move the current value every 10th frame, so every 10 frames, the value will be updated. Then check if the absolute difference is less than 1000. Then we simply assign target value to current value. Because the difference is so small, there is no reason to be fancy. Otherwise, you want to add the difference between target value and current value, divided by move factor. The higher the move factor variable, the smaller increment your money will be moving on the counter. Assign current value to the text. Now we need to call moveTo instead of setTo. Keep setTo on the start. You will be calling setTo every time you want to set the value without playing the counting animation. While you will be using moveTo when you want your counter to slowly count over the target value. Good, this is it for this episode. If you have any questions or any ideas about code, please leave your comment below. If you are interested in seeing what will come out of this, please subscribe. If you want to support further, you can find my Patreon in the description. Special thank you to Andrew V. Long for his generous support. With best regards, see you in next episode.